These are 5 reasons why the Arkham Origins remaster is 99.9% real, at least in my mind. At number 5, the Suicide Squad teases. Arkham Origins was the first Arkhamverse game to officially tease the Suicide Squad, and since the upcoming Suicide Squad game is set in the Arkhamverse, it makes total sense to bring this game back into the spotlight. Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League needs all the help it can get. At number 4, the Age of Remakes. I'm not sure why, but we live in it. We get a ton of remakes, and it's starting to look like the 7th console generation will be getting its wave soon. We already got remakes of Last of Us, Dead Space, and it was leaked a while back that Assassin's Creed 4 is being remade, so why not Arkham Origins? At number 3, the darker tone. Batman games usually have a relatively dark tone, but Origins was dark even by Batman standards. Bruce Wayne, he was much angrier. He was much more violent in his younger years, and the developers did a really good job of making Gotham City feel dirty and dangerous. At number 2, it's not remastered yet. Did you know that every other Arkham game has been remastered or re-released at least once? The Return to Arkham Collection was a huge graphical update for Asylum and City, and then the upcoming Arkham Trilogy Collection is bringing all 3 Rocksteady games to the Switch. But why has Origins been excluded? Could it be because Warner Brothers has bigger plans? At number 1, Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League. The upcoming Suicide Squad game is going to bring us back to the Arkhamverse for the first time in almost a decade. But put simply, there's not a lot of hype. The Arkham IP is extremely valuable, but Warner Brothers is going to completely destroy it if they release Suicide Squad without any help. That's where Arkham Origins Remaster comes in.